What's up, guys? This is your boy, Strattron. Welcome to my very first tutorial for Sony Vegas 10. We're going to be doing just a basic transition and show you guys what I mean right here. From my montage, a transition of how the metal up here, as you can see, goes into another clip of how to do that, so we'll just be learning how to do that. It's real quick and really easy and can be used for doors, windows, anything that you want. So go ahead and exit up out of that. Open up Sony Vegas here. So it should only take us a few minutes to actually do it. I'm not going to explain what everything does. If you guys want me to do that in another tutorial, then that's fine, but do what I do and it should come out the same. So you're going to import your two clips, the one that has like the metal or window or door or whatever, and then whatever clip that's going to go into it. So these are just two test clips. Alright, this one should have... Wow, this shit laggy. So we're gonna make it smaller. I usually run on preview auto and then 29.9, and then whenever I go to take pictures and do other like editing that requires frame by frame, then I will turn it over to best full and then like 59.9. So this is my first clip. That's gonna be the metal right here. Right there. This is what we're gonna use for our transition. So we'll go ahead and move it a little bit forward, make it look all cool, like right there. Go to best, put it on full, go over to file, click on properties, go up to the frame rate, change it to 59.9, and this is all for a HD PVR Hypahog 1212. So, and then from there we're gonna take a picture with this little button up over here that looks like the save icon, and we will name it a tutorial pick, and then it automatically uploads into the project media above. So you're gonna drag the picture down here into the timeline and put it up in a video track of its own, and then there will be a track below. The picture must be above it for it to take effect. If you put the video above the picture, then it just like won't work. But anyways, come up over here, click on event pan and crop, come up over here to position and mask in the bottom left corner, click on the empty square box to make it checked. Then you're gonna come up over here and you will notice that your cursor is changed into like a little black pointer, and that's what you're gonna make to use your cutout. So we'll just cut this out real quick. Not gonna be perfect or beautiful, but it's gonna do the job. So that's our picture right now. We just cut that out. I could cut out the gun and all that, but that will be a later tutorial. So we're going to come up over here to the mode. It's on positive. We're going to click it over to negative. Go up over to the feather type. Click on both. The feather percentage, I usually just use 1.0. So we now have made it like that. We're going to go up over and click on position now. It's going to change back over into this. I usually have that clicked off if I'm doing this transition, and what this does is make the screen go in at all four points like equally. If you click it off, then it only makes one corner go off, or from like whichever point that you are using. So we're gonna go ahead and come up over here into the timeline, click forward a little bit, we'll go about 12 frames. And we'll move this in and upwards. And if you notice up over here in the preview screen, it's moved a little bit forward. And then we're going to come up over here onto the timeline again and move it forward. And now we're at like about 20 frames right there. And we're going to move it in again. And then one more time at 22. And you want to make sure that the box right here is small enough to fit into whatever target that you are using the transition with, like if it be a tree or a door or window, whatever. So now our transition is complete. You can close up out of that. Remember that it's whatever length you made it. The length that I made it is 22, so we're gonna come up over here, grab the picture, left click, drag it back until the timeline ends, or until the like cursor that is right there, and then the video itself you're gonna left click and drag all the way back to the very beginning of the picture, so it should look like that. Come back up over here, click on preview, auto, file, properties, 29.9. So now we'll go ahead and do this and just render it real quick. If you guys saw, there's our transition just like that, real quick. We're gonna go and drag this clip up over and put it up in behind. And then re-render it again like that. If you guys look up over here in the preview screen, you can see it going off, and that's what it should look like if you follow what I did. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and render this out for you guys, and we'll be back in a few minutes. What's up, guys? We're back now. It's all done rendering up, 6 minutes 4 seconds for me for a 25 second clip. That's right, badass. I uploaded it to YouTube because it seems like Camtasia can handle that a little bit better. Show you guys the clip real quick of what my clip looked like so you guys can see it. And anyways, guys, if you enjoyed this tutorial, I'm sorry that I said look up over here and so on, whenever you guys really don't know where the fuck I'm talking about. I'll try to improve on that a lot better in the next tutorial. But if you guys did enjoy, be sure to comment, like, favorite, and subscribe. If you have any problems or questions, be sure to comment below or send me a private message. But I'm out of here for this tutorial. You guys have a good one. Later.
Enemy infantry spotted!